Stanford University.
Virtual reality, VR, gives you the impossible. So you can experience situations that aren't possible in the physical world. In terms of the environment, when you think about climate change, it's very abstract. We don't know exactly what it's going to look like. It's far off in the future, and people don't have direct experience. For the past 13 years, we've been putting subjects, experimental subjects, into virtual reality, showing them some future version of the environment, tying that environmental change to human behavior, in fact, their behavior, and allowing them to experience that cause and effect relationship in a way that's very visceral and very intense.
We collaborated with two teachers at a local high school to take one of the virtual experiences from the lab here and bring it into their marine biology class. In the virtual world, the students found themselves on the floor of a Mediterranean reef. They're surrounded by rocks and coral and sea urchins and sea snails and a whole variety of fish. We talk them through what ocean acidification is, how as human activity is putting more and more carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, a big percentage of that carbon dioxide is absorbed by the surface waters of the ocean, which gets transformed into carbonic acid, which breaks down into other compounds, which just wreaks havoc on the ecosystem. And so they basically watch the world kind of evolve over time. It basically ends with only a few species left on this reef, and then they're told to look down at their body one last time as they're the last coral standing on this reef, and they literally watch their body collapse. So we're still parsing the results, but it looks like that the students who had the virtual reality experience, they reported a greater level of concern for the impacts of human activity on the environment, a greater sense of ownership for the environment, and a greater sense of their ability to positively impact the environment.
So the reason we're doing this research is to create a medium that can viscerally show people ocean acidification exists, it's real, and it does great harm to the animals below the sea. What our experiments have shown is that virtual reality as a medium is very effective at getting people to change not only what they say, but what they actually do. The idea of virtual visits to nature is controversial. Nothing should replace the real thing. However, we can't have 10 billion people on the planet and all of them going to visit the Great Barrier Reef. It's just not sustainable. So if we can replace some of those visits with virtual ones, these visits can be better for the consumer and there can be less wear and tear on the environment.